Okay, so we were discussing the concept of angular momentum in the last class, very weird thing. And I told you that angular momentum for a moving point particle, angular momentum for a moving point particle is found by this method, which is the same method as we used to find torque, except for the fact, of course, that here instead of force, you will have the momentum vector, right? Everything else remains the same. And then I told you how to find the angular momentum of a rotating object. So if you see a rotating object, that means that one point on the object is fixed. Then you use this, okay? L is equal to I omega. So angular momentum is weird because angular momentum should have been only I omega because linear momentum is mv. Since angular momentum is also defined for linearly moving particles, that is why it is weird. Okay, so we found out the angular momentum of this rotating object, right? स्मित, आज मैं भेज दूंगा ये, नहीं भेज पाया, कल भी नहीं भेज पाया, ये पूरा नोटबुक ही शेयर कर दूंगा। ओके रजत, आज ट्राई करेंगे खत्म करने का, बट नेक्स्ट क्लास में रहेगा। ओके, सो द लास्ट थिंग अबाउट फाइंडिंग आउट एंगुलर मोमेंटम दैट वी लर्न इज द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम रिजिड बॉडी एग्जीक्यूटिंग ट्रांसलेशन प्लस रोटेशन। तो अभी तक क्या हो रहा था, दैट जो ट्रांसलेशनल पार्ट था और जो रोटेशनल पार्ट था, हम उसको ऐड कर दे रहे हैं, राइट? सो काइनेटिक एनर्जी अगर निकालना था तो काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ रोटेशन प्लस काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ ट्रांसलेशन, राइट? दिस इज व्हाट वी वर डूइंग अप टिल नाउ, एंड वी विल कीप ऑन डूइंग दैट ओनली, राइट? थोड़ा सा केयरफुल और रहना पड़ेगा। सो जस्ट लाइक ऑल द प्रीवियस क्वांटिटीज, द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ सच ए पार्टिकल विल हैव ए ट्रांसलेशनल कॉम्पोनेंट एंड इट विल हैव ए रोटेशनल कॉम्पोनेंट। The translational component will be found by considering the rigid body as a point particle at its center of mass, then finding the angular momentum of this point particle, right? Now we have already discussed how to find the angular momentum of a point particle. And this guy is perhaps the easiest, is equal to I COM omega. Okay, the rotational part is always equal to I COM omega. You don't need to bother about any axis, anything. Just find the moment of inertia about an axis passing through the center of mass multiplied by the moment. Okay. So you have to be careful about the fact that these two guys may or may not have the same direction. Okay, so it is quite possible ट्रांसलेशनल और रोटेशनल वेक्टर का सम नहीं होगा, नहीं, थोड़ा सा अलग है, थोड़ा सा अलग है. सो दे मे और मे नॉट हैव द सेम डायरेक्शन. दैट मीन्स दैट इट मे हैपन दैट द ट्रांसलेशनल पार्ट इज क्लॉकवाइज एंड द रोटेशनल पार्ट इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. इट मे हैपन दैट बोथ ऑफ देम आर क्लॉकवाइज. इट मे हैपन बोथ ऑफ देम आर एंटी क्लॉकवाइज. इट मे हैपन दैट वन इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज एंड द अदर इज क्लॉकवाइज. Just have to be careful. But there is nothing new here. We have already learned how to find the angular momentum of point particles. And we have already learned how to find the angular momentum of rotating objects. So the angular momentum of an object which is rolling, which is translating and rotating will be given by a translational part and a rotational part. The translational part will be found by considering the rigid body as a point particle. Rotational part will be found by I omega. Okay. So this should be absolutely clear. There is nothing new that I have told you. In fact, it is the old pattern. The only thing new that that I think that I have told you is the thing that I've written in black, and that is that the translational and the rotational part of the angular momentum may have different directions. So a solid sphere is rolling without slipping as shown, with constant angular velocity omega. हो गया जहर, लिख लिया?
हाँ सर.
अभी मैं जूम आउट भी कर देता हूँ. सो यू सी द सॉलिड स्फीयर इज रोलिंग विदाउट स्लिपिंग एज शोन. फाइंड एंगुलर मोमेंटम अबाउट ओ. लुक एट द रेड सेंटेंस. Look at the red thing. Look at the green thing. First, forget about the green thing. Only look at the red thing and apply it. Then, forget about the red thing. Only look at the green thing, apply it. Be careful about clockwise, anti-clockwise, and then add them up. Mass is M. Yeah. Mass M है, radius R है, constant angular velocity omega.
देखो इट शुड बी राधिका 5R + 2R, देखो अरिजीत यू आर राइट एंड जोहेब, एम आर ओमेगा क्या होता है भाई, एम आर ओमेगा का क्या यूनिट रहेगा? देखो सिली मिस्टेक किया है, और मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया क्या लिया है, सॉलिड स्फीयर है ना जोहेब, एंड आई ऑल्सो नीड टू नो द डायरेक्शन. हाँ वेरी गुड इश्यू. हाँ अब उसको अप्लाई करो इश्यू, जो 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 उसमें सबसे कॉम्प्लिकेटेड चीज है आपको पहले से पता है, आपने ऑलरेडी लिख दिया. हाँ बिल्कुल सही. आई थिंक यू मिस्ड आउट द डिनोमिनेटर, बट आई थिंक कुछ इनकम्प्लीट आंसर लिखा है, बट आई थिंक यू आर राइट. हाँ, बट व्हाट इज द डायरेक्शन? हाँ ये आंसर बिल्कुल सही है. हाँ नहीं, ये सही है बिल्कुल. राधिका डायरेक्शन गलत है. वेरी गुड अभिजीत, ये सही डायरेक्शन. साई ये थोड़ा सा गलत आंसर है ना, देखो बिकॉज सॉलिड स्फीयर का मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया तो 2/5 mR² होता है ना. हाँ इनकॉर्पोरेट दैट इनटू योर कैलकुलेशन एंड यू शुड गेट द करेक्ट आंसर. सो फर्स्ट आई वॉन्ट टू फिगर आउट द ट्रांसलेशनल कॉम्पोनेंट, देन द रोटेशनल कॉम्पोनेंट. ट्रांसलेशनल कॉम्पोनेंट के लिए आई फॉरगेट अबाउट द फैक्ट दैट दिस इज अ स्फीयर. फॉर मी दिस इज अ पॉइंट पार्टिकल मूविंग अलॉन्ग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन लाइक दिस विथ ए वेलोसिटी ऑफ आर ओमेगा because it is rolling. Rolling implies, rolling means that velocity of center of mass must be equal to r omega. So therefore the momentum vector is m into r into omega, and I extend the momentum vector and I drop a perpendicular onto this extended line. So the translational component of the angular momentum is equal to linear momentum, which is mass into velocity, multiplied by the length of the perpendicular, which is equal to r. This is equal to r. And to find the direction, I just keep my pen on the tip of the momentum vector and twist it towards the origin. And I find that it is going clockwise. So this must be clockwise. Now, finding the rotational part of angular momentum is the easiest thing. Rotational part of the angular momentum is the easiest thing. It is equal to I cum into omega, and we know that for a sphere, I cum is equal to 2/5 mR² multiplied by omega. And you can see from the diagram that omega is clockwise, so this must also be clockwise. Okay. So I can now write the final answer. The angular momentum is equal to
एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा प्लस 2/5 एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा, दिस इज इक्वल टू 7/5 एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा, राइट? एंड आई वांट टू राइट द डायरेक्शन एज वेल, सो आई विल राइट माइनस के कैप, सिंस रिमेंबर क्लॉकवाइज इज माइनस के कैप एंड एंटी क्लॉकवाइज इज प्लस के कैप.
हाँ, स्मिथ पहले वाले टर्म पे देखो ना, हल्का सा गलती किया, राइट? सो व्हाट यू डन इज इन द फर्स्ट टर्म यू रिटन ओनली द लीनियर मोमेंटम, इट इज द लीनियर मोमेंटम मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस. सो दिस इज द लीनियर मोमेंटम एंड दिस इज द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस. थोड़ा सा, यस यस, वंस. सो बाय द वे गाइस, दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड इन आईआईटी जेईई एडवांस्ड एग्जाम. ओके, दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड आई थिंक 2000, मेरे को एग्जैक्ट याद नहीं आ रहा है, यू कैन सी इट इन द पास्ट ईयर पेपर्स. एंड दे हैड, दे डिड नॉट हैव अ सॉलिड स्फीयर, दे हैड अ सिलेंडर. सो दीज आर द काइंड्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट. Okay, and after 6 months, after 5 months, I don't expect you to remember the details about this, but I do expect you to work out the angular momentum of a translating object, of a rotating object, and of a translating plus rotating object. Okay, without making any silly mistakes. This is the level of question that you will be getting in the IIT JEE advanced exam. Of course, I will be going much beyond that. And the reason that I will be going much beyond that is that I cannot really predict what is going to happen in the IIT JEE advanced exam. Therefore, I would like to make you ready for any eventuality. And therefore, I thought I'd say all tough questions discuss. But this is it. This is the level. Advanced exam. Okay. Clear as up to, this is clear to everyone. Anybody having doubts? So in the advanced exam or in the mains exam, okay, you will find that there are at least 60% questions. At least minimum 60% questions which are directly formula based. So if you remember the formula, you crack the question. I mean, there is no concept, there is nothing to think about. Keval formula agar aapko aata hai, aap values dalenge aur aapka question hoga. So 40%, roughly 50 to 60% questions are formula based, and 40 to 50% of the remaining question, thoda sa, they require some thought, right? So when you are giving the advanced paper, or when you are giving the advanced paper mein thoda ye ratio kam ho jayega. Of course, advanced wale paper mein there would be around 10%, 20% of questions which would be directly formula based. Remaining would be multiple formula based. It will not be only ki aapko ek formula yaad hai to ho jayega, right? Lekin mains mein meri guarantee 50 to 60% of the question direct formula lagao, answer aa jata. To isiliye hum chahte hain ki jab aap finally वो exam दें January में या February, whenever it happens, then you should not be unable to do a question simply because you don't remember the formula. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए. हाँ, conceptually नहीं आ रहा है आपको वो, you know that this is how to find the angular momentum, you remember this, you make a silly mistake, or there is some twist in the question which is not being solved by a direct application of this formula.
एंड यू कुड नॉट डू द क्वेश्चन, दैट्स ओके, दैट्स फाइन. लेकिन ऐसा क्वेश्चन आया और आप नहीं कर पाए, ये नहीं होना चाहिए, राइट? आई मीन दिस इज डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला बेस्ड, देयर इज नथिंग टू थिंक अबाउट हियर. ओके, चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं. कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर हाँ, जो हमारा जो मेंस का एग्जाम होता है वो जेई मेंस से बहुत ज्यादा टफ होता है. ओके, एंड व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू वंस वी फिनिश द सिलेबस एंड स्टार्ट द रिवीजन इज दैट वी आर गोइंग टू बाय यू नो दैट यू नो दोज बुक्स जिसमें कि पास्ट ईयर के क्वेश्चंस होते हैं चैप्टर वाइज. सो व्हेन वी डू द रिवीजन, मोटे वाले पतले वाले क्या फर्क पड़ता है? नहीं नहीं बहुत पेपर वाले नहीं 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 बहुत पेपर वाले नहीं, जिसमें कि पास्ट 17 इयर्स या पास्ट 19 इयर्स के मेंस के पेपर होते हैं चैप्टर वाइज. तो जब अपन रिवीजन करेंगे ना, तो जैसे लेट्स से दैट आई विल रिवाइज इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स, तो वो नहीं नहीं पैटर्न नहीं मिलता है. 37 इयर्स वाला हाँ, जो एडवांस्ड वाला होता है. Let's say that I revise electrostatics. जो दिनेश सर पढ़ा रहे हैं वो मैं रिवाइज कराऊंगा. When I revise electrostatics, then I would expect that in that time, you do all the questions from the mains वाला book and from the advanced वाला book, which is of electrostatics, right? And at the end of the day, the person who is setting the paper will not be looking at Zeal का paper है या Allen का paper है. They will be looking at the previous papers only, right? They will not be bothered about coaching में क्या पढ़ाया जाता है, ठीक है ना? हाँ, per chapter revise होगा तो कितना time होगा per chapter? That will vary, of course. We can finish the revision in around 2 months, 2.5 months. So you'll have the real hard work, the real thing will start. Portion kab tak khatam hoga? Portion khatam hone mein mere khayal se August, September tak we should be, September end we should be looking at finishing the portion, right? But it is very easy. The exam itself is very easy. It is only a mental game. If you give up mentally, then of course nahi hone wala hai. But if you just keep at it, main abhi fir se bol raha hu, physics is the easiest of them all. Kyunki 50-60% questions will be directly formula. So if you keep at it, if you remember the formula, that's it. You are going to crack the exam as far as physics is concerned. चलो, सो लेट्स अब फॉर्मूला से दूर चलते हैं और थोड़े मेरे वाले डोमेन में आते हैं जहां पे कुछ नहीं समझ में आता किसी को. सो कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम, राइट? सो व्हाट यू नीड टू टेक अवे फ्रॉम दिस, व्हाट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इज दैट इफ वी हैव द ट्रांसलेशनल डोमेन, then we know that F external is equal to dP by dt. The Newton's second law, external force is equal to rate of change of linear momentum. Similarly, in the rotational domain, we have external torque is equal to dL by dt, right? Now you can ask, अरे ये कैसे आया? So this is not a very difficult thing to do. I can simply write R cross here and I can simply write R cross here. And therefore, this becomes, I can then rewrite this as d by dt of R cross P. And that's it. This is linear momentum and this is external torque. Okay? So external torque is equal to dL by dt. Now, once you understand this, that external torque is going to change the angular momentum of an object. If there is no torque, right, we have already discussed this. If there is no torque, the angular velocity of the object does not change. If there is no external torque, the angular momentum of the object also does not change. Okay. So therefore, we come to the last law, last conservation law of mechanics, right? And that is that if the external torque on a system is zero, then this implies that dl by dt is equal to zero. This implies that the angular momentum of the object must remain. Angular momentum of the system, which may comprise of multiple objects, will remain constant. It cannot change. So, what does this imply? So supposing that we have a rotating object, then what this means is that I omega will always be equal to constant, right? So supposing we have a rotating object and external torque on it is equal to zero. This would mean that I omega is constant. This would mean that I1 omega 1 would be equal to, that means I1 omega 1 would be equal to I2 omega 2, right? What this means is that if you look at the system at a certain point of time, right, and if the moment of inertia of the system is I1 and its angular velocity is omega 1, and you look at the same system after some time and you find that the moment of inertia has changed to I2, then this would mean that its angular velocity will change to omega 2, right? Very, very interesting applications come from this, right? So I'll show you a couple. Let me see.
ये बच्चों को मैं सिखा रहा हूँ आजकल cos zero जो होता है one होता है exoplanets के बारे में बता रहा था मैं सबको दिखाई I hope everybody can see this right.
Yes, sir.
Let's see if I can find some. No, YouTube पे सर्च करना होगा ना वीडियो देखना है तो. Conservation of. Okay, so this I think is one of the
Grammarly can help you write quickly and
Grammarly available. I think I can play it here on this. So if you look at the if you look at the moment of inertia of the professor, then the moment of inertia will change because he will hold these hammers first close to himself and then away. So the moment he does this, the angular momentum has increased.
sorry, the moment of inertia is large, and now when he pulls them near to himself, the moment of inertia decreases and omega increases. And omega decreases, omega increases, omega decreases, and so on. So there are many other examples. This I think is a क्या है हाँ सो ही इज ट्राइंग टू एक्सटर्नल टॉर्क ऑन द सिस्टम इज जीरो सो लुक दे हैव स्प्रेड देयर बॉडी आउट एंड व्हेन दे सॉर्ट ऑफ पुल देयर बॉडी इन द एंगुलर मोमेंटम विल बी कंजर्वड एंड देयरफॉर द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इफ दे रिड्यूस द एंगुलर वेलोसिटी विल इंक्रीज राइट आई डोंट नो व्हाई दे आर नॉट शोइंग शायद यहाँ पे आएगा right so angular momentum is constant and she is going to decrease the moment of inertia by bringing the body closer to the axis right and the angular velocity increases by a huge amount okay. So this is the conservation of angular momentum. There are so many other concepts, so many other applications of this. So it turns out that the angular velocity of the Earth will change if you build high-rise buildings, right? Why is this? Because the Earth is a sphere, right? And if you build a high-rise building, then you are taking mass away. I increase it. So if you are building a high-rise building, then you are taking mass away from the surface of the earth, right? Upper. And therefore you are increasing the moment of inertia of the earth. And if you increase the moment of inertia, then then omega will decrease. Okay. Yeah. So the more buildings we build, the moment of inertia of the earth increases and therefore omega decreases. The decrease of course is insignificant because the earth is so, so large, right? But at some point of time, it may become significant. Okay. Wheel axis mein kya hota? Haan. Okay. So moment of inertia is a three dimensional. What happens if moment of inertia is in three dimensions? Moment of inertia is in three dimensions, then weird things will happen. And I will show you one. कौन सा दिखाऊं मैं ये थोड़ा लंबा वीडियो है इसलिए मैं दिखाऊं ठीक है फास्ट कर देता हूं So what would happen if you change the axis? अभी तक जो moment of inertia ये change हो रहा था, this was happening for uh, कहाँ है वे?
So I have weights on the ends of my arms here. I'm holding on to them. If I put them out, I'm going to have a lot of momentum, even if I'm moving slow. All right. And then if I pull the weights in, if I spin this wheel up and get it going really fast, I now have angular momentum in this bicycle wheel because it's spinning around and around. The entire wheel has angular momentum. And it so happens that if I try and turn the wheel a new way, it will fight against me. It won't let me turn it just a little bit. And it turns out that because it has all this momentum, it actually helps you stay upright when you turn your bicycle. And it keeps you from falling down once you get moving. And it's to turn. It can also... So now I can use that angle momentum of the bicycle wheel to spin my around when I'm on top of a little platform. If I turn the bicycle wheel, I start spinning. And then if I turn it straight, I stop and I can spin back the other way, one way, and then spin back the other way. Well, anyway, I can spin one way really fast. This is Dr. Carlson. Or, and then if I turn.
Right, so what is happening is that he's holding the wheel like this. Right? When he's holding the wheel like this, angular momentum is here. The angular momentum is here. And then what he does is wheel ka axis has a change kar diya. Lekin jab wheel ka axis aise change kiya to is direction mein angular momentum create ho gaya. Yeah, is direction depending on how he has turned the wheel. Remember that the direction of angular momentum is given by the right hand rule. Curl your fingers of the right hand and the thumb gives you the direction of angular momentum. So here, the angular momentum is along the x-axis. Okay, I don't know whether it is positive or negative, but the angular momentum is along the x-axis. Now, the moment he stands on this, and usne usko vertical kar liya. ठीक है ना, वर्टिकल कर लिया तो इस डायरेक्शन में एंगुलर मोमेंटम आ गया, लेकिन एक्सटर्नल टॉर्क तो जीरो है तो एंगुलर मोमेंटम इस डायरेक्शन में आ ही नहीं सकता है। इसका मतलब कि इस डायरेक्शन में एंगुलर मोमेंटम जीरो रहना चाहिए क्योंकि पहले भी जीरो था, बट दिस गाय हैज लिटरली क्रिएटेड एंगुलर मोमेंटम इन दिस डायरेक्शन। तो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज क्रिएटेड इन दिस डायरेक्शन, राइट? Now, angular momentum is created in this direction. Ka matlab, there must be something rotating the other way around. So, who is rotating the other way around? Guy himself is rotating then the other way around. Right? Mere usme chal raha hai, aapke usme nahi chal raha hai. Right? So, I hope this is sort of gives you an idea of conservation of angular. But conservation of angular momentum is so much more than I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2 because I1 omega 1 and I1 omega 2 are just, I kaise change aayega when he, I did not change this time. This is not I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. This is the fact that there is no angular momentum along the z-axis, and this guy when he turns the wheel, translational wala bhi andar hoega, when he turns the wheel he creates angular momentum here, which is not possible because there is no external torque. Therefore angular momentum is created here as well, and for this angular momentum to be created the person goes round and round and round. Chalo, okay. we'll be discussing this in detail. This is very very basic, and ye jo two dimension wala hai, this is beyond our syllabus. We won't be talking about that, of course. But this thing that I have written is only applicable when you have only rotating rigid bodies. Right, but we have gone beyond this. We know that angular momentum is there for translating objects. We know that angular momentum is there for translating and rotating objects. So we will be applying the full thing. ये डिले क्यों है? मेरा हाथ तो यहाँ है. ओह
जब आप लिख रहे था स्क्रीन फ्रीज था हमारे.
हाँ सर, जब आप लिख रहे थे हम वीडियो देखते.
ओह रुको एक बार मैं स्टॉप करके फिर स्टॉप शेयर एयर प्ले. So, just like I have all along this chapter, we will talk about conservation of angular momentum. First, so thoda sa difference hai. First, only for rotating objects, okay, endpoint particles. And then for rotating and translating object. Now, how did I start conservation of linear momentum? What was the first question that I gave for conservation of linear momentum? If you remember, there is a railroad cart on a frictionless rail, and there is a person standing on one end of the cart, and then that guy decides to jump off. And then you had to find the velocity of the cart, right? Now, what was the catch? What was the trick? What was the only thing where I could make things complicated? Because ultimately, m1 v1 is equal to m2 v2 is very easy. So what I did was I gave you the velocity of the person who is jumping with respect to the cart. And the catch was, the trick was, the thing to be careful was that when you apply m1 v1 is equal to m2 v2, when you calculate the initial momentum or the final momentum of the system, the velocities of each and individual particles that you are writing down in this equation must be with respect to a single frame. And I said that the frame that we will prefer is the ground frame of reference. Okay. So the thing carries over here as well. I will give you a system. Let me write it down. Application of law of conservation of angular momentum. So the first step is to identify the system and its components, right? So aap ye conservation of angular momentum laga ke is cheez pe rahe, right? In the videos that we saw, for example, this video that we saw, Dr. Carlson's Science Theater, we will apply the law of conservation of angular momentum on the system consisting of man plus that bicycle wheel plus that platform that guy was standing on. Okay? So there would be three components. You can consider the man and the platform as one. In that case, there will be two components of the system. Man plus platform, component one, and the bicycle wheel, component two. Right? In this example, where we had the skater, where we had the ice skater, that is very obvious, the ice skater would be the system, right? Single object in the system. So first thing you have to do is identify the system and its components, just like you had to do in linear momentum. लीनियर मोमेंटम में वो क्वेश्चन में जो रेलरोड कार्ट वाला क्वेश्चन था उसमें दी
components of the system were the railroad cart and the man, right? उसके बाद से मैंने एक और क्वेश्चन दिया जिसमें कि रेलवे कार्ट था और उसके दोनों एंड पे या सेम एंड पे दो आदमी खड़े, तो उस केस में द सिस्टम कंसिस्टेड ऑफ थ्री ऑब्जेक्ट्स, रेलवे कार्ट एंड द टू मेन ए एंड बी, एंड देन वन ऑफ देम जंप्ड ऑफ, राइट, एंड द क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड अगेन, देन द न्यू क्वेश्चन, ए न्यू सिस्टम मस्ट बी कंसिडर्ड, एंड द न्यू सिस्टम वॉज रेलवे कार्ट एंड द पर्सन on the railroad cart. The guy who has jumped off is now now not a part of the system. So you have to identify ki kis system pe aap conservation of angular momentum laga rahe ho. Wo system jo hai, it consists of only one object, or it has two objects, or it has three objects. So number two. Now in conservation of linear momentum, we had to identify the direction along which the external force is zero. उस direction में हम linear momentum को conserve कर सकते हैं. यहाँ पे not only do I have to decide where external torque is zero, but I also have to decide along which axis external torque is zero. Because different axis पे I will get different values of torque. So I must choose. I must be very clever. I must be very wise in pinpointing the axis about which the external torque is zero. There may be other axes about which external torque is not zero, and about that axis, about those axes, the law of conservation of angular momentum will not work. So identify the axis about which external torque. Okay, then the third is identify the event. So for example, in that conservation of linear momentum, the event was that the person is jumping off the cart. Fourth is that you have to apply or equate rather, equate the angular momentum before the event to the angular momentum. The fourth step is the hardest, of course, because angular momentum nikalna padega, aur angular momentum nikalne ke liye hame pata hona chahiye ki object ka motion kaisa hai. To object ka motion agar linear hai, linear ka matlab sirf straight line nahi hota hai, linear ka matlab gol gol bhi ho sakta, right? Isme confusion nahi hona chahiye. Uniform circular motion agar ek particle execute kar raha hai, so you can consider that as rotation, or you can consider that as translation agar wo point particle hai to. पावर वन मतलब नहीं समझ में आ रहा है, किसी और से भी बात कर रहा है क्या तू? नहीं नहीं, इसमें ये जनरलाइजेशन मत करो, राइट? इन केस ऑफ रोलिंग वी विल अप्लाई एंगुलर एंड लीनियर मोमेंटम. नो, लीनियर मोमेंटम का एप्लीकेशन का कंडीशन अलग होता है, एंगुलर मोमेंटम का एप्लीकेशन कंडीशन अलग होता है. अगर दोनों हैं, सेटिस्फाइड हैं, तो आप दोनों लगा सकते हैं, नहीं तो नहीं. हाँ, रजत क्या बोल रहा है? इक्वेशन का पावर वन फॉर, हाँ, तो क्या स्क्वायर थोड़ी ना इक्वेट करेगा? सीधा इनिशियल एंगुलर मोमेंटम निकालना है, फाइनल एंगुलर मोमेंटम निकालना है, इक्वेट कर देना. आया समझ में रजत? यही पूछ रहा है ना, आई होप. रजत?
हाँ सर, वही पूछ रहा था.
चलो,
So, corresponding to the cart and the man wala problem, we have a merry-go-round, we have a disc. And this is the axis of the disc. Disc is fixed. And we have a person standing on the edge of the disc. The mass of this person is M, and the mass of this disc is capital M, and the radius of this disc is R. Okay. So now let me write the question. A disc of mass M, radius R, is fixed to move, fixed to move, as an example. Fixed about its center and is free to rotate. A person of mass M initially at rest at a point on the rim of disk starts moving with speed V naught along the rim. If V naught is equal to speed with respect to ground, find the angular velocity of the disk. Right? And I want to write one more thing here. External torque about the red axis is equal to zero.
Right. Now, ye zero kyun hai external torque? Ye main abhi batata hun. But aap pehle isko try to solve this. Try to apply
these four steps.
This is a completely analogous problem to the man and the cart. Completely analogous. Bilkul same. एम और एम भी आएगा ना उसमें, आई मीन द मासेस आर डिफरेंट राइट, द आंसर कैन नॉट बी So, let's look at the steps one by one. First, we have to identify the system and its components. This is easy. The system is comprised of the disk and the man. Then we have to identify the axis about which torque external is zero, which has already been done for us. Red axis is where torque is zero. Identify the event. This is also easy. The person starts to walk along the rim. And we have to equate Li and Lf. Right? So let me just write this down. This system is disk plus man. The axis about which external torque is equal to zero is red axis. Event is the person starts to walk, okay, and then the equation is Li is equal to Lf. Now, Li must be the angular momentum of the man plus angular momentum of the disk. Final angular momentum must also be angular momentum of the man plus angular momentum of the disk. Zero plus zero, because there is no motion initially, man is standing still. Now comes the part that you have to understand. Finally, what is happening and how do I calculate? Well, finally, this person is moving with a velocity V naught along the rim, with a speed V naught along the rim of the disk. So if I were to look at the situation from above, okay, if I were to look at the situation from above, then this would be the red axis, of course, and this would be the man.
and the person would be walking with some velocity, some speed, V0 like this. So therefore, what is the angular momentum of the man? Well, I will treat the man as a point particle. And I will say that, look, the linear momentum vector of the man is mv0 like this. We'll drop a perpendicular from the chosen origin. So the angular momentum of the man must be equal to linear momentum multiplied by distance plus the moment of inertia of the disk. Now, what is the disk doing? Well, the disk is rotating. And we know that if a rigid body is rotating, then the angular momentum is given by I omega, right? In this case, since the axis is the axis of the center of mass, there is no complication whatsoever. So I will write down mr square by 2 into omega, right? And we have to find omega. So this means that omega is equal to minus mv naught, 2mv naught by capital M. What does negative sign tell us? What does the negative sign tell us? Negative sign means, negative sign means that omega is opposite to the angular velocity of the
If you say that you already know that the disk will rotate
in the opposite direction, then you can take mv naught r minus mr square by 2 omega. In that case, you will get the value.
सर तो फिर पॉजिटिव आ रहा है ओमेगा
तो आपने पहले ही डायरेक्शन अज्यूम कर लिया ना
हाँ तो फिर हाँ सर सर
तो मैंने इसमें डायरेक्शन ओमेगा का कुछ अज्यूम नहीं किया है ना या प्लस लिखा है तो मैंने सेम डायरेक्शन अज्यूम कर लिया है मेरे को नहीं मालूम है क्या ओमेगा का डायरेक्शन तो आंसर मेरे को ऑटोमेटिकली बताता है कि ओमेगा का डायरेक्शन ये हो अगर आपने भी ओमेगा का डायरेक्शन गलत भी अज्यूम कर लिया और आंसर नेगेटिव आया अजम्पशन के बाद तब भी इसका मतलब है कि आपने डायरेक्शन ओमेगा का गलत अज्यूम कर दिया ओके क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 रिपीट क्वेश्चन 1 इफ वी नॉट is equal to velocity with respect to disk. Okay. So repeat this question. If the velocity V naught is not with respect to the ground, but is with respect to the disk, तो बहुत लंबा चौड़ा आंसर है यार ये तो नहीं नहीं इसमें गलती क्या करी है मैं बता रहा हूँ इसमें गलती क्या करी है तो व्हाट यू हैव डन स्मिथ इज दैट यू हैव taken the man not only as a point particle but also as a rotating object. आपने angular momentum उसका दो बार निकाला, इसलिए गलत आ रहा है. अगर आप आदमी का एंगुलर मोमेंटम निकालना चाहते हैं तो आइदर ट्रीट दैट पर्सन एज ए पॉइंट पार्टिकल एंड फाइंड द एंगुलर मोमेंटम ऑफ ए पॉइंट पार्टिकल, और सिंस द पर्सन इज गोइंग राउंड एंड राउंड ट्रीट इट एज ए रोटेटिंग ऑब्जेक्ट एंड देन फाइंड द एंगुलर मोमेंटम, नॉट बोथ.
सर मतलब ऐसे केस में सिर्फ उसका रोटेशन काउंटर पार्टी आएगा ना एंगल मोमेंटम का?
नहीं, थोड़ा देखो, जब रिजिड बॉडी होती है ना, आपको दिखाई दे रहा है कि डिस्क है, स्फीयर है, सिलेंडर है, रॉड है, जब रिजिड बॉडी है आपके सामने तब आई ओमेगा लेना चाहिए. अगर एक तार है, एक एक पर्सन है, एक ब्लॉक है, उसको हमेशा एज ए पॉइंट पार्टिकल ही ट्रीट करना चाहिए. ऑल्दो द आंसर दैट यू विल गेट विल बी सेम. अगर ये आदमी गोल गोल घूम रहा है तो इसका एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज एम वी आर और एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा, बोथ आर सेम. बट टू कीप द क्लैरिटी इन आर माइंड्स वी मस्ट ट्रीट person, car, block, wedge as point particles. नहीं, इसमें आंसर में माइनस नहीं आना चाहिए. अगर माइनस आ गया तो फिर लोचा हो गया. माइनस का डिनोमिनेटर में अगर माइनस आ गया तो लोचा हो गया. हाँ बिल्कुल सही. बस B को इलिमिनेट कैसे करें, जैसे बिल्कुल वैसे ही जैसे कार्ट और मैन प्रॉब्लम में किया था. वी नीड टू फाइंड वी नॉट, वी नीड टू फाइंड वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्राउंड. वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्राउंड वी नीड टू फाइंड. वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द डिस्क इज गिवन. सो यू विल राइट डाउन वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन. उत्कर्ष बिल्कुल सही. सो यू राइट डाउन वेलोसिटी ऑफ मैन with respect to disk is v naught, and this would mean that velocity of man minus velocity of disk is equal to v naught, and therefore velocity of man, which is what you want to find, is equal to v naught plus the velocity of the disk, which is equal to r omega. So, initial angular momentum, the final angular momentum of man plus angular momentum of disk, angular momentum of man, angular momentum of disk, 0, 0, angular momentum of man is equal to mv into r plus angular momentum of disk is equal to mr square by 2 into omega. Here v is equal to velocity of man with respect to ground, right, given that velocity of man with respect to disk is equal to v naught. So this will be equal to velocity of man minus velocity of disk. So velocity of man is equal to v is equal to v naught plus velocity of disk. So therefore v is equal to v naught plus r omega. Right? So now let's place this into the equation. So this guy will become 0 is equal to n v naught plus r omega into r plus mr square by 2 into omega. So omega is equal to minus m v naught r divided by mr square plus mr square by 2, which I can write as mv naught upon r m plus m by 2. स्लाइड्स कहाँ होती है यार, अब तो एक ही वो होता है. क्या हुआ? अभी मैं पूरा भेज दूंगा. हाँ, पाथमैन का भी अगर आप रोटेशनल लोगे तो आंसर सेम आएगा. आई एम टेलिंग यू आंसर सेम आएगा, बट व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट if you are doing that, there's no problem. आप अपने एंड से थोड़ा केयरफुल रहना, बस डबल कैलकुलेशन नहीं करना.
सर,
हाँ
सर, इनिशियली अगर विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ग्राउंड नहीं दिया, मतलब इनिशियली डिस्क भी रोटेट कर रहा है और मैन भी चल रहा है, तो सर अगर उसके हिसाब से हमने इनिशियल में दोनों का, मतलब जैसे आपने जीरो लिया, वहाँ पे हमने वैल्यूज पुट किए तो v और बाद में उसको v not plus v किया, उससे आएगा क्या आंसर?
नहीं, उससे क्यों आएगा? You have changed the conditions of the question. The question is very specific that the man is standing still at the rim. So what is the event in the question? The event is that the man starts to walk. So before this event, before the man starts to walk, the man is standing still. There is a whole reason that the disc starts to rotate. The disc starts to rotate. Why? Because the man starts to walk. So the question that I'm asking is, the first question that I asked was that if the man starts to walk with a speed v naught with respect to the earth, then what will be the angular velocity of the disc? And the second question I've asked, if the man starts to walk with a velocity v naught, the speed v naught relative to the disc, then what will be the angular velocity of the disc? Right. So initial angular momentum has to be zero. You cannot take it as something else. Okay, next question. So टू कोएक्सियल डिस्क्स आर रोटेटिंग एज शोन. When joined together, right? इसका मतलब ऊपर वाले डिस्क को नीचे वाले डिस्क के ऊपर रख दिया. After some time, they start rotating with the same angular velocity. Find this angular velocity. So you have two coaxial disks. They are rotating same direction. And then you keep one disk on top of the other. Obviously, थोड़ा सा friction होएगा बीच में, थोड़ा सा स्लिपिंग होएगी बीच में, बट आफ्टर अ वाइल दे विल स्टार्ट टू रोटेट विद द सेम एंगल वेलोसिटी. व्हाट इज दैट एंगल वेलोसिटी? मैन का रोटेशनल और ट्रांसलेशन दोनों क्यों नहीं लेते हैं? रोटेशन और ट्रांसलेशन साइमल्टेनियसली केवल एक रिजिड बॉडी का हो सकता है, पॉइंट पार्टिकल का. पॉइंट पार्टिकल कैन नॉट ट्रांसलेट एंड रोटेट. इनफैक्ट पॉइंट पार्टिकल कैन ओनली ट्रांसलेट. Take 1 minute. This would be completely analogous to block of mass and moving with velocity 2v collides with another block of mass 2m moving with velocity 3v and they stick together. Find the final velocity of the blocks.
बिल्कुल सही है, दिस शुड नॉट बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. सो वी मस्ट हैव आई वन ओमेगा वन प्लस आई टू ओमेगा टू इज इक्वल टू आई वन प्लस आई टू इंटू ओमेगा, राइट. अगर ये ऑपोजिट घूम रहे होते हैं तो आई वन माइनस आई टू इंटू ओमेगा हो जाता. What are the individual terms here? This is the moment. This is the angular momentum of disk one. This is the angular momentum of disk two before combination, and this is the angular momentum of the combined object. Right? It is just like m one v one is equal to m one plus m two into v. So all I need to do now is put in the values. MR square by 2 into 5 omega plus MR square by 2 into omega is equal to MR square by 2 plus MR square by 2. पहला वाला इज 5 बाई 2 प्लस 81 बाई 2, 5 81 प्लस 5 इज 86 बाई 2 एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू 82 बाई 2 एम आर स्क्वायर ओमेगा डैश लिखना चाहिए. MR square cancel हो गया. Omega dash is equal to 86 upon 82 into omega, which is equal to कितना है? 43/41. Okay, now please start with HCV angular momentum वाले questions. You will not be able to do collision वाले question. तो जहाँ पे यू सी कि एक पार्टिकल आके दूसरे उससे कोलाइड कर जा रहा है, लीव देम फॉर द मोमेंट. बट आई थिंक देर आर अराउंड 7 or 8 क्वेश्चंस दैट यू कैन डू. लेट्स सी, उनको आप खत्म करिए, नेक्स्ट क्लास में हम कोलिजन करें. ओ वेरी नाइस, ओके ठीक है, तो नेक्स्ट क्लास में हो जाएगा, ठीक है ना. नेक्स्ट क्लास में वी विल बी डूइंग कोलिजंस.
सर इस क्वेश्चन में
हाँ
फ्रिक्शन की वजह से स्लो डाउन हो रहा है तो उसका भी टॉर्क कंसीडर करना पड़ेगा?
नहीं, वो एक्सटर्नल टॉर्क नहीं है, इंटरनल टॉर्क. टॉर्क व्हिच इज एक्टिंग बिटवीन द टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स विल बी इंटरनल एक्सटर्नल. चलो ठीक है गाइस, सो आई विल सी यू. ही करेंगे मनीष, अभी खत्म कहाँ हुआ है यार. इसका प्रैक्टिस आपको करना है एचसीवी से, और एक वो भेजा था ना, सीरीज ऑफ क्वेश्चंस भेजा था ना दिनेश सर ने.
डीपीपी
सर दो बुकलेट्स हैं.
हाँ
दो बुकलेट्स भेजी थी सर ने स्टार्ट में, उसमें से करना है क्या?
हाँ हाँ उसमें से. ओके ठीक है, मैं अभी भेजता हूँ, ये नोट्स भेज रहा हूँ. चलो
थैंक यू सर.
इसके बाद क्लास है या खत्म
है?
पोस्ट किसको बनाऊं? चलो बाय
बाय. थैंक यू
बाय सर.